Hello, and welcome to your technique video for chemical equilibrium and LeChatelier's principle. You will need to have your goggles on anytime the chemicals are out. At the end of the lab, all of the solutions can be flushed down the sink as long as they are diluted with plenty of water. The procedure for this lab is written out step by step and is straightforward, so we will not show you the whole thing. However, we perform steps 11 through 18 so that you can get an idea of what each part of the lab will look like. Before doing this, we would have done exercise 1 so that we could identify what each complex looks like in solution. First, weigh out about 0.5 grams of copper bromide into an Erlenmeyer flask. Then add 1 milliliter of distilled water. Record your observations in your notebook and compare to your observations from exercise 1 to identify the predominant compound. Then keep adding distilled water 1 milliliter at a time until there is a total of 15 milliliters in the flask. Record your observations again and decide what the predominant species is now. You have to go to the hood to add the ammonia because the fumes are strong. When you are looking for this reagent, you will find it labeled ammonium hydroxide. This is because it undergoes this equilibrium reaction in water. You will add 6 molar ammonia drop by drop until no further changes occur. Record your observations and decide what the dominant species is. Next, you will add 6 molar nitric acid until the solution returns to how it looked before. Record your observations. What is the predominant species here? Try this part again. Go add the ammonia until no further change occurs, then add the nitric acid until it goes back to its original state. Would you say that this equilibrium is reversible? Get another test tube and pour 5 milliliters of your copper bromide solution into it. Add 1 gram of potassium bromide to the solution. Record your observations and decide what the dominant species is. You will place this test tube in a hot water bath and then in an ice water bath. Again, you will record these observations and decide what the dominant species is. From this, you should be able to determine if the reaction as written is endothermic or exothermic. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next week.